Hey peoples, this is Boom J. Welcome to my channel. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. God bless and thanks for tuning in.
Real quick, what I'm trying to show you on this is pretty much how to add machine as a plugin. So I'm gonna close all this stuff that I have open. So one of the first things you do when you, this is Cubase 5, in continuation from what I did before, Cubase 5 is what I've used. I love it. I mean, it's a bit old, but it works for me. And you know, I've used Cubase for a very long time, from Cubase 3 to, they may have had a 4 at the time, but I think I remember a 5 coming out, and I had got the 5. And I have all my settings in the 5, and I've transformed them from system to system, pretty much. It works for me. You know, it's not really about the DAW that you use, because you got all these plugins that you can use. The only way it affects you is if certain things start changing, like the OS, the Mac operating system, or the Windows operating system, the computer system that you use changes, the 64 to 32 bits, all that stuff, then you got to think changing. I know they do improve on the new ones, but it's still the same. So I use machine as my production outfit, and I simply add machine as a plugin in Cubase, and you know, record my vocals or record whatever I need to record. So to add Cubase as the vocals, you visit devices. You can go to VST connections. This is pretty much to add your. This is where you add your audio interface, all right? So you can click add bus, mono, stereo, whatever you need to do. And then you go to add, you go to plugin information first to look at what's happening. Usually sometimes when you install machine or install other softwares as plugins on your computer, it may show up in here. But that doesn't necessarily mean that it's been added to Cubase, so Cubase can see it. So you can go to VS2 plugins, go to add, find machine. Machine is usually downloaded in the C, native instruments, VS2 plugins, 32-bit, 64-bit, depending on what your computer is or what your Cubase software, if it's a 64, 32-bit, software, that's the one you choose. So you choose that, hit OK, and then it's in here, hit OK, and then you come in here and do update plugin information. Once you do update plugin information, it updates everything in here. What I will do, I will restart my computer and then log back in, open up Cubase. Once you open up Cubase, open up your file, the file that you want to work on, open up your new page, and you go back to devices, go back to VST instruments. On number one, pull down the menu, you have all your VSTs. Machine 2 is right there. You select machine 2. Okay, so if I'm here, do a devices, VST instruments, select machine 2. Say, do you want to create a new MIDI track? Yes, I want to. It opens this up. So I'm actually gonna go in and select one of my tracks in here. Boom, it shows up. This is how it shows up. So, it's asking for Massive and Reactor. So those I gotta add as VSTs too, but that's fine. And so what you can do is you can play, you can actually play that instrument. So this is an instrumental that I have, right? But this is not the original instrument. The original instrumental for this in Cubase is actually this right here. Yeah. That's like the original. So the actual, the two instrumentals they complement themselves really, so it's a good thing. So I might just work out with this instrumental. This is one of my production songs. I'm still pressed when I'm sleeping. Evidence proved that I'm still living. Days of a lies, boy, I stop counting. Make hay while the sun's still shining. What I do, girl, you can't call me. My dad almost passed, you fake it hit. Money in the bank, who's gonna chase? All right, so that's pretty much how you do it. So you have a machine, want to add it to Cubase. I'm sure the latest versions of Cubase might have the same. It might be, the interface might look different, but it might be the same concept. So make sure in device plugin that you have it in there. If not, you go to VS2, you add it, you update, restart, and then you go back to devices, VST instruments, and you add. You know, it's a better way to do your production on cube, on a machine. After you're done producing, then when you're trying to lay down vocals coming to your DAW, it could be Logic, it could be Pro Tools, but I'm sure you can import in Cubase, add the plugin as a machine, it will open up, find the file, it will open up as this. But mind you, the changes that you make on here while you're in Cubase, the changes you make on here will not change, will not have effect on the actual, the original recording from your cube, from your machine software. So if you make a change in the plugin in Cubase, it will not save on the original recording in the machine. But that's okay, because you have it in there already. So that's about it, and I appreciate you watching. If you have any questions, write me and you comment, and I can answer, based on this. All right, thank you guys, and thank you for watching.